books as I read in December, which is 9 books. So that means I can only buy myself 9 books, because some of these I did get for free. So once I spent money on that, that's when I can close an eye. So just to make sure I don't spend a ton of money and all of that. I'm looking at this. I am behind 3 days of my reading, but I have read 10 books this month. So I'm not really behind, but kind of behind by the calendar wise. So I do have this major. So I have purchased 7 books this month, and 2 of those are for 2. So I've purchased 7, and then I got 2 books for free. So I'm allowed to buy myself 1 more book to equal 9 books. I don't think that's going to happen. I don't think I'm going to buy another book, because I'm not going to any stores or anything. So bookstores for the rest of the month. So I don't think that's going to happen. So I'm like, should I take that extra slot and add it on to next month, allowing myself to buy an extra book next month, or should I just leave it in January? Let me know, because I'm unsure. This is something just new I'm doing in 2023, so I'm not positive exactly what I'm doing yet. So we're going to be adding these books into Goodreads story graph, and then to my little sheet here that I put in my TBR jars. So we're going to start with my most recent one that came into my possession, and then the first one. So the most recent is a new release, and that is In Time of Our History. I don't know. The viewfinder's upside down, so I don't know really which way to show y'all stuff. But In Our Time of History is by Susan Mari. And I got this book for $13.59 at Target. So I can throw away that receipt now because I've used it. So we're going to put that on our note card here. I don't like calling it by the wrong name. And I'm using pencils now. I got some pencils for Christmas. So I have an eraser. It's so handy. In Time of Our History. So that's really neat. And this was part of Joker. Used to charge.
Science fiction.
pretty sure this is going to be considered historical fiction, but you never know. Yeah, historical fiction. Yeah. Queen of Thieves, that sounds like such a fantasy title. Story graph. It's very nice. And like I said, same cover. That's the digital version. So let's see if it's like the same amount of pages. I don't want to put it as digital because then when I start reading it, it's going to think I'm reading a digital copy and mark it as an ebook. So I just gonna go with. Oh, this is so difficult. I'm like, what do I do? What do I do? I think we're just gonna type in. We're gonna search by IBSN 978014. I never know if you're supposed to put the options. 21, 80, 82. Oh, but one came up, so. So, this is a book that was nominated for the Booker Prize this past year, and this is Glory by Violet Bluio. This one I got for $13.59, which is a great price for a hardback from Amazon. When at last the Father of the Nation arrived for the Independence Day celebration, is now earlier than 3:28 in the afternoon. The citizens congregated at Chidada Square. Since morning had it worth waiting. They could have raised all Chidaya with their frustration alone, that is, if Chidaya had also been any other place. I probably pronounced that wrong, my apologies. It's not part of the book. And every one of them understood. The new national anthem, though, will contain an anthem that spoke the kind of glory that burns eternal and glows with living light. Okay, so glory. I thought this was nominated for the Booker, like nothing was coming up. So let's type in IBSN 978 05 26 1 2. Oh, that was someone that I'm sorry.